Hi everyone, welcome back to Growing Large Veggies and Fruits in Containers series. Today I'm going to share with you some tips on growing zucchini in containers. Now, if you're growing in a small space like a patio or a deck, you might think you can't grow large vegetables. Not so. I'm actually growing zucchini, eggplant, tomatoes, and yes, even watermelon in 20-gallon Smart Pots containers. So make sure you go back and watch the first few videos in the series so you know exactly how to get started. Along with sharing some zucchini container growing tips, I'm also going to share with you how to deal with common problems that affect zucchini plants, such as blossom end rot and powdery mildew. But before we do that, I'm very excited to share with you my very first harvest of the season from the zucchini plant. My zucchini plant is growing absolutely fabulously in this 20-gallon Smart Pots. And first off, I want to say thank you so much to Smart Pots for partnering with us on this episode. They have a fantastic fabric grow bag container, and this one actually has handles so I can move it around if I need to. But the great thing about Smart Pots is they are porous fabric, so the roots air prune, which means that they don't circle around the pot, but instead they grow a nice fibrous root ball, which actually allows the plant to grow quicker and larger. So this plant has only been in this container for about 6 weeks. It started off as a small little transplant, a few inches high, and wow, what amazing growth. And I already have a zucchini to harvest just 6 weeks after planting. Now you can see this absolutely beautiful zucchini right here that is the perfect size to harvest. And right next to it is a small, tiny zucchini which didn't get pollinated. So I'm actually going to remove this small little zucchini that didn't get pollinated and harvest the large one and take it inside to eat for dinner tonight. Harvesting a zucchini is super easy. What I like to do is simply twist it very gently from the stem. I don't like to use a knife or scissors because I don't like to risk cutting the main stem of the plant. So just twist it very gently. And there we go, it's harvested. Now I do like to harvest them when they're small. This one might be a tad bit on the oversized side, but when you harvest them and they're small, they're nice and tender, and this one will be great on the grill or roasted up in the oven. And these things produce like crazy. So if you want to grow something that's going to give you lots and lots of food, zucchini is the plant for you. The first tip to growing zucchini successfully in containers is to provide it with some support. Now, zucchini does grow like a bush, does tend to have some vines that trail off throughout the growing season. But here I have just a simple store-bought tomato cage placed deep in my container. And zucchini has such large leaves, so you're not really trellising the entire plant, but you're just feeding the leaves up through the tomato cage as it grows. So you want to come out here and check your plant every couple of days. And that way it provides, it saves some space and provides your container with the support that it needs, because you're going to be growing a lot of really large vegetables on this plant. Second tip for growing zucchini successfully in containers is to hand pollinate if you need to. Now, how do you know if you need to hand pollinate your zucchini? Well, remember this small little tiny zucchini I picked off my plant at the beginning of the video? This zucchini did not get pollinated by the bees, so that's a real sign, if you're seeing a lot of these on your plant, that you need to get out here and hand pollinate. Because of course you want to grow nice big zucchini like this so you have a lot to eat. Now, I'll put a link up above. I just did a video in detail on how to hand pollinate watermelon. It's exactly the same for zucchini. The third tip for growing a nice crop of zucchini in a container is to make sure you're watering it enough and to make sure you're feeding it regularly. Now, container plants definitely dry out faster, are depleted of nutrients quicker than plants you might grow in a raised bed, so you definitely want to keep up with that. Now, I have all my container plants here on a drip irrigation system. They're on a timer, so they get regular watering. But if you don't have a drip irrigation system for your containers, you want to check it daily to make sure it's not drying out. You do that simply by sticking your finger in the container as far down as you can get it, or even pulling up some soil. You can see here, this soil is pretty dry. My plant definitely needs some water. So I'm going to show you how to water it today and also show you how to fertilize it at the same time. Fertilize your zucchini container plants with a good water-soluble fertilizer. My favorite is Vermisteria Worm Tea, which is definitely water-soluble. And that just means that the nutrients, all the beneficial bacteria and microbes in this worm tea are going to be immediately available to my plant. So I'm just going to add 3 to 6 ounces per gallon. So I'm adding 6 ounces to my 2-gallon watering container here. and I'm going to water my plant with it until the water runs out the bottom. Now, the nice thing about growing in smart pots is that the fabric is aerated, which allows the water to drain properly so the roots don't get waterlogged. And it also helps the plant to breathe, which keeps it cooler on a hot summer day. I'm going to give my plant a nice little drink in just a moment, but before I do that, I want to talk about a few things that are common to zucchini plants. You might notice the leaves are drooping here. Well, it's very common in the midday sun for the leaves to droop like this, but it doesn't necessarily mean they need water. So don't run out and water your plants right away just because the leaves are drooping, because if you overwater it, the roots will rot and your plant won't grow properly. So always check for water first, like I showed you earlier, by checking the soil. If it feels dry, definitely give it some water. If it doesn't feel dry, don't water it, and most likely your leaves will perk right back up in the cool of the evening. Now, a few other issues that are very common to zucchini. The first one being blossom end rot. Here's what blossom end rot looks like. You can see this zucchini here has kind of a soft end to it, like it's kind of rotting. And this is caused either by one of two things, either by a lack of calcium in the soil or by underwatering, so the plant can't take up the calcium that is in the soil. The problem of blossom end rot is very easily solved by one of two things: by making sure that your plant is on a regular watering schedule so it can take up the calcium that is in the soil, or by adding calcium to the soil. Now, I'm going to add some calcium to my soil today by crushing up a couple Tums tablets which have calcium in them and then watering them into the soil, and that will help solve the problem for any future zucchinis that grow on this plant. So I'm just crushing up my Tums tablets till they're a really fine powder. I'm going to sprinkle that around the base of my plant. Then I'm going to water with my watering can that has the worm tea in it. Get it nice and soaked. I'm going to water at the base of the plant, so avoid getting the leaves wet and avoid getting powdery mildew. And I'm going to water the plant until the water runs out the bottom. The other problem that regularly plagues zucchini plants is powdery mildew, which is the bane of any gardener's existence. If you've never seen powdery mildew, it's a white powdery substance that tends to coat the leaves of your plant in warm, wet weather when the leaves don't have a chance to dry out. And it's a bacterial infection that will spread to your other plants. You can help keep it under control by avoiding getting the leaves wet, so by watering at the base of your plant, and also by using a really simple foliar spray. This time I'm actually using the Vermistera worm tea again, a couple tablespoons in this quart-sized spray bottle. The worm tea works great as a foliar spray because it coats your leaves with a protective film of beneficial bacteria and organisms that grow and multiply on your leaves and crowd out the diseases that tend to develop on your plant leaves, and also help protect it from pests. So I like to do this early in the morning before the sun comes out, and that way it has the day for the leaves to dry before the evening hits, and that way it'll avoid your leaves being wet overnight. Now, if you do notice some powdery mildew on your leaves, or if your leaves start getting kind of old and yellow looking, this one's got a little bit of yellowing around the edges. What I like to do is just come in here and snip off the leaf as close to the base of the plant as you can. And pretty soon you'll see some new growth appear. That also helps to keep a large plant like this under control in a small growing space. Thank you so much, Smart Pots, for supplying the containers, for partnering with us on this episode. To learn more about Smart Pots, go to smartpots.com. I'll also put links down in the video description and on my website and my Amazon store on where you can purchase them. Well, I can't wait to get inside and cook up some of my freshly harvested zucchini and eat it. It's going to be so delicious. But comment below, let me know if you're growing zucchini or any of the other large vegetables from this series in containers. I'd love to hear your growing tips as well. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.